Hello students, this is Richa Handa, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, DP Vipra College, Bilaspur, Chhattisgarh. Today I am going to give lecture for BSc first year students on the subject for Computer Science and Information Technology. And my paper name is Programming in C Language. And I will cover the topic of Unit 4, that is pointers. In my previous lecture, we have learned about the pointers and how it is used. Now, in this lecture, we will learn about the pointer versus array, the array of pointers and pointers to array. So first start with, we know that what is a pointer. The pointers are used to store the address of a variable. And we know very well that the array is a homogeneous data elements that are used to store the elements of the similar type. So we have now to find out the difference between the pointer and array. We know very well, but how we are working with them together and how they are used together. So when we declare an array, we know that the sufficient amount of the memory is allocated by the compiler to store all the elements to the array. That means, suppose if we declare the array of the size 5, then it declares the size 5 for us to store the 5 elements in the array. And if we want to store the 10 values, then it will give us the memory space to store the 10 variable, whatever the data type it is, depends on our declaration. And the base address of the array is known as the first element of the array, and it is also located by the allocated by the compiler. And suppose we declare the name ARR here. You can see here in the example, we declare the array name ARR and its type is integer. That means store only the integer variable of the size 5. That means we only store the 5 elements in that. And these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have taken the integer variables. And here you can see here, this is the array of the size 5. ARR 0 is represent the first position of the array ARR, and it represents second position of ARR, third position, fourth position, and fifth position. The subscript of the array is starting from the 0. And it is the address, that is the 1 is stored in the address 101, 2 is stored in the address 103. 3 is stored in the address 105, and 4 is stored in the 107, and similarly the 5 is stored in the 109. We all know about that, but we can understand, and here the variable ARR will be used to contain the base address which point to the first element of the array, that is ARR0, that is 101. That means if we are using here ARR0, that means it represent the base address, that means 101, it represent the first address of the array. So variable ARR has the two purpose. That means it is the name of the array, as we know that whatever we declared here, if the name of the array is of any thing that whatever you want, suppose the area or a circle or a triangle, whatever you want, no, then this represents the base address of the array. And it also acts as a pointer that point towards the first element of the array, because as we know that the base address or the name of the array is also represent the base address of the array. That means the first address of the first element stored in the array. So we can say that ARR is equal to address of ARR0. ARR0 means first value that is stored in ARR. And when we use ampersand before that, that represents the address where 1 is stored. Okay. And ARR is the name of array. It also used to store the base address of the array. So we can understand it through this example. Hash include stdio.h, conio.h, these are the header files, wide main from where the program going to start, and between the curly braces, open curly braces and closing curly braces, we write our program. Here in this program, we declare the ARR, that is the array of size 5 of the integer type, contain the 5 elements. And we also contain a pointer variable, that is of integer type. Why? Because it is used to store the address. Here, P can be equal to ARR, because ARR store the address of the first element. Or we can also use it like that, P equals to address of ARR. 0. Both are same, because ARR also contain the base address and also the base address. Okay. And we use the for loop to display all the values that are stored in a particular addresses. That means we are getting the values from the address. How? We print here %d slash n and pointer p. That means pointer p means p represent ARR, address of the first element. The address of the first element is 101, and when we use the pointer before the pointer variable, it represents the value that is stored in a particular address. That means p represent 101, and when we use pointer here, that is represent only 1, that is the value stored in a 101. And when we increase p plus plus, that means we have learned from the last lecture pointer arithmetic, that means it add 2. Because we are using integer, integer contain the 2-byte location. If we were using character, then it incremented by 1, and when we are using float, it incremented by the 4, and when we use double, then incremented by the 8. So here we are using integer, so it is incremented by the 2, because from 101 it is incremented to 103, which is the address of the 2. Then 105 is the address of the 3. So similarly, we have print 1 to 5 elements all about. Okay. Now come to the next point, that is array of pointers. In the last sections, we have learned about array and pointers. And here we are using array of pointers. That means we have created the array that is stored the address of the different variables. Okay. So for like that, we have used the syntax data type, pointer, name of the array, and size. Like that, if we are using integer type of array, so we declare data type integer. Pointer ARR is the name of the pointer array that contain the address of the only 3 elements. So we can understand it through this example. Here we declare integer pointer ARR 3. That means we have declared an array of the size 3 that contain the address of the 3 variables. So for that, we need 3 variables that we are going to store. So we have declared 3 variables here of integer type, a equals to 10, b equals to 20, and c equals to 30. There is again a one another variable I that is used for looping purpose. Okay. And here ARR 0, that means first position of the array contain the address of A. And address of and ARR of 1 contain the address of B. ARR of 2 contain the address of C. And how it works, you can see through this example. Here, this is the array ARR, and ARR of 0 contain the address of A. A, here this one, contain the value 10, stored in the address 101. Here B contain the value 20, address is 103. Here C contain 30 or 20, whatever you want, and address is 105. So we can say here, say that ARR of 0 contain the address of A, ARR of 1 contain the address of B, and ARR of 2 contain the address of 3. So this is the array that of the pointer type. That means because it stores the address, not the value. And we display the address and the value using the for loop. I equals to 0, I is less than 2. For 0, we have used the array of 0. Address of array of 0 is whatever. Address of array of 0 is 101. And because ARR of 1 contain the value 101. And value should be pointer ARR of I. If we are using ARR of I, that means 101. And when we are using pointer before 101, that means the value that is stored in the 101, that is 10. So the value should be 10. Then we increase it, then become 103. Value will be 20. And when again we increase it, value address is 105 and value is 30. Okay, now come to the array of pointer with the string, because here we use array of the pointer using the integer variable, and here we see how the array of pointer work with the string variable. So pointers are used to handle the character array with the number of rows and the varying length. We can declare it like that: character, pointer, name of 3. That means we have declared an array of called name, is called a name, and the size is 3. That means it's to store only the 3 elements. We have used the 3 city names here, that is Bilaspur, Raipur, and the Nagpur. But you see the difference here. Here the first address of name or first position of the name contain the address of B, only the first address of the first element, not the address of all the characters that are used in Bilaspur. Okay, and similarly, the second one contains the address of R only, not the whole Raipur, and third one contains the address of N only, not the all address of Nagpur. That means it contains the base address only, not the address of whole the string. So the memory space should be used very low as compared to the other variable, because it contains only three location for the pointer. But what happened when we are using the same type of thing but without using the pointer? Okay, let's see how. Suppose this is the array, but without using the pointer. We are not using pointer here because the name is a simple array, two-dimensional array, 3 rows and 10 columns represent. We are using 3 cities name, and each city name contain the 10 characters mostly. And the name are same, Bilaspur, Raipur and Bhopal. And here we contain the Bilaspur, contain the, and 10 spaces are allocated to them. And same Raipur and same the Nagpur. But you see here, it contain 4 and 4, 8. And it contains 6, and it contains 6 characters. And when we are using with pointer array, it uses only 3 memory location, but it uses how many memory locations? It uses 8, 6 and 6. And you also see that the sum of memory spaces are going to be wasted here. Okay, so we can say that if we want to use the character with the pointer, character variable with the array, then we should use the pointer with the array, because it contains the 3 row and extended in the 10 memory location for the column. We can understand this through like that. When we use the array of character without using the pointer, then the memory wastage is more, because more memory space is going to be waste. And hence it is preferred to use the pointer in such cases, because if we want to not waste our memory space, so we use pointer in such type of cases. So when we talk about the memory wastage, it does not mean that the string will occupy the less space. Actually, it will take the same space. But when we define the array of character, a continuous memory location will be used, and so that the memory space should be wasted, because we do not need the continuous memory space to store all the characters. So which can be avoided if we are using pointer here. So I hope you all are understand about the array, pointer, pointer of array and pointer of a string, pointer of characters. So if you understand it, then it's okay. Otherwise, you can comment me if you have any doubt. Also, thank you so much.